Hi everyone, welcome. From this video, you will know what is named rotor outlet in Angular Router and how it allows you to have multiple activated routes at the same time. My name is Mitch Romzhensky, and before we dive into the code, please subscribe to this channel and don't forget to check out my Angular Material Theming video course. The link and promo codes will be in the video description. And now let's move forward. Alright guys, let's imagine that we're going to build the application which consists from some navbar with links to different entities. Then we have some sidebar where we render previews for these entities, and if we select one, we see more details in this bigger area. Yeah, it might be some complex form here, and the same design we see for products as well. So sidebar with previews and bigger area reserved for product details. And despite the sidebar for products and users might look similar, in fact, they may have completely different layouts. Like products may have also some sub-navigation where I can navigate between different type of courses. It's highly dynamic environment. And additionally to these requirements, we have another, and namely it should be stateful. So means that if I copy current link of this application and send it to another user per email or whatever, when they open this link, they should see the same state. So there should be selected products page, courses for Angular, and namely material theming course should be rendered in product details. So it should be restorable. And besides this, it should have independent navigation. I mean sidebar and product details. So if I navigate from Angular to just courses, it should not affect anyhow the product details window and so on and so forth. So basically we want to fork our activated routes to two independent instances which live independent life. Yeah, and this is where named router outlets can help us. Good. There is an application which looks very similar to what you have seen before on the slides, and I prepared this application for this particular tutorial, and you can see the user page which has kind of list of different users, and if I click on some of them I see some user details. Yeah, and if I go to photos I completely switch the page. And I see kind of previews, right? And I can click and see also details. And as I said, the behavior is a little bit wrong, or not wrong, usually it's fine, but this is not behavior I would like to have. I want when I navigate from, for example, from photos to user, I want that photos details stays on the page, so it should not switch the page completely. And let's refactor it and make it work as we expect. So before we start refactoring, just give me a few minutes to show you the code inside. So there is the app component where we have toolbar, and we have the content where we have this directive router outlet where we render some user or photos page. And this is our app routing. You can see this is very similar. We do redirect from the root route to the users, and for users we render user page component, and then we have child route for user ID, which renders already a user details component. And let's have a look at the user. I will show only this part because photos pretty much the same as a user. So it consists from three components. First one, it's a page which has just a sidebar and section for details. Inside the sidebar, we render user sidebar, and here we have the router outlet where we render this child route for users, or basically details. Sidebar is very simple component where I just pull users from some remote server and render it within ng for a loop right here. Details, pretty much similar. I have I read the ID param from my route. Yeah, so this means this one parameter I read here. Here is I fetch and do a request to the server to fetch data for this user with this ID. Very simple. Yeah. Now let's go back to app component and let's talk a little bit about router outlet. In most of the cases, you use it like this. So this is so-called primary router outlet, right? And not everyone knows that this directive has another property, and this property called name. And here you can already define some sort of name for your router outlet, and I will call it details. So here we're going to render our details section, this the big one, right? And I would say if we leave it as it is, our layout will be broken a little bit. So I would suggest you to grab this part from user page, and we will adjust it like this. So instead user sidebar, we're going to render our primary route, because we need to keep at least one primary route. So I will use it for our sidebar. And for the details, we're going to use the named route, which is actually entity details, right? So far so good. It should work fine. I save it, and the next step is to adjust our app routing, because now we have two router outlets and router should understand how to resolve it, and we have to help router with this. So this first route stays as it is, but users route we have to adjust a little bit, because we are not going to render the user page component anymore. Instead, we're going to use the sidebar component, user sidebar component, yeah? Because primary route reserved for the sidebar part. Cool, now we don't need children as well, because we don't have any more these parent-child relationships. They are independent roles already, so we put it next. Right after the users, and here I will adjust it. I will add something like user ID, like this. And we're going to render the user details component, but additionally we have to define in which exactly router outlet we have to render it. And in order to do this, we should say that we should add the property outlet and say in which exactly, and in my case this is details. Here we go. Now we can save actually and test it. So I go to my application, I navigate to users, and you can see that users were created as expected, right? However, we don't see any details. Even if we click, we see nothing, because currently we have wrong link here, yeah, which leads to user slash ID, but we don't have such a router already. And we kind of forked our router to do independent ones. So how we can resolve it in the URL? And actually, Angular introduces the alternative syntax for named router outlets. And it starts up with the parentheses, and inside parentheses you say the name of the router outlet where it should be rendered. So it is details. And then after semicolon, you have to define the path to this to the component which you want to render. So this is in our case user slash ID, right? So I say that it should render user one. Let's keep a user with ID one. Yeah, and now if I navigate to this path, you will see also user details was rendered instead of router outlet with name details. Yeah, it is broken a little bit. We will fix it in a minute. This is just a CSS issue, but this is how, this is kind of alternative router state for our named route. Okay, so let's go back and I will fix this part by adding display flex, and hopefully it should help us. Sorry, it should be added to the content, not to the host. And now, yeah, you can see that everything works fine. All right, but it's kind of annoying to manually write this syntax, right? So we should do it automatically by clicking on some user, and let's adjust it. And I will go to the user sidebar, and here we have to modify router link. And here we're going to cut this part. And how we will do this, because now we have two routes, kind of, yeah, we have to say that for the first route, please let's stay on the same state, on the same path. So I provide just empty string, and then I have to provide the additional config. This is the object, and this object has property outlets, which has another object, and here the key is the router outlet name where we want to set the state. So in our case, this is details. Okay, and here already the value will be some array, and I say that, okay, it should be a user, and the second parameter, it's a user ID. So it will be mapping this path, all right? So, and now if I save it and go back, and maybe let's remove it, or yeah, remove it. And now if I click, you can see that we were navigated automatically to proper route. Yeah, and I can switch between them and everything works as expected. Now we have to do pretty much a similar for photos, right? So let's do it. Here we have to say that for photos, we're going to render photos sidebar component. Then we remove children and introduce the new route. And here will be photo ID. Oops, I forgot a slash. Photo ID, and it renders photo details. And we say that it should be rendered inside outlet, also details. Yeah, and let's immediately adjust the router link as well. So I will copy this part here, and for photos I will do the same. Here we go, but instead here is the photo and path to the photo as well. Good, now we can check if it works fine. So here everything stays as expected. Then check, I navigate to photos, but user details stays because we changed only primary route, and it was not, and our details was not affected by this. So the part which is responsible, which associated with the primary route, was switched, but not the named part. Yeah. So it allows us maybe we would have functionality like drag and drop. Yeah. From here, from the sidebar to some user details. Why not? That could be such a workflow. But we will not implement this in this video, but if you ask me in the comments, why not? We could do it. However, this is how it kind of works. Yeah, two independent roles, everything is fine. But here's the question, how we can close the roles. Yeah, maybe we would like to do it as well. And you, in order to do this, you just have to provide null here for as a value for details outlet, and let's quickly do it. Maybe in some app component, I will introduce the link here, and this link is going to be the material button with text maybe close, and here's the router link, which should lead to empty path, but here we provide outlet, and here should be details, and we say that it's gonna be null. So if I navigate here and click close, you can see that our details disappeared, or the button stays. Maybe it would make sense to put it somewhere inside this detail component, or you know what, by the way, if you didn't know, router outlet has some events like activated, I believe, yeah, and we could handle it and hide the button. Depends if it's activated, we can show button. When it's deactivated, we can close this, but we would need to introduce some property here. Let's say is button visible, which is by default, it is false. And if we activate, it should be like true. And if deactivated router outlet or route for this outlet, we will say that it should be false, like this. And here we have to, for the button, create something like and display if the button is visible. All right, so I navigate, we see close button. When I close, disappears button and disappears details. I don't know, maybe this is not the best solution for this, definitely, but I just wanted to show you these events. Maybe you didn't know about this, so now you know, and you can catch them somehow and, you know, do your some custom logic. All right, guys, that was it. I hope the information was useful, and if so, please share this video with your colleagues, because it is really the best thing you can do in order to support my channel. Besides this, don't forget to leave your honest feedback in the comment sections, because eventually it allows me to improve my content quality for you. I wish you a productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next videos.